throws the kid up. Kwajo doctor, Kwajo mayor doctor, doctor. The parents were doing that. Even when the kid is as dumb as anything, you know. Kwajo 1+1=7, Kwajo 5, hey, what about them? But still, mayor doctor. Parents were doing that. But now it's changed. Yesterday, I close from work, I met one parent with a kid. Kwajo as somewhere, I'm like, wow. Don't let me hear you say, Kwajo Razak, grandma, man. It's amazing, you know, but most of us have motivations. You know, motivations, I was motivated by my mom to be a doctor, of course, not the comedy part. The comedy part is my dad, not. My mom motivated me to be a doctor. How many of you had parents in the house who were doctors in the house? They never went to the medical school, but they would attend to you. Yeah, Ghanaian parents, a round of applause for them, our moms. Look, unlike a white setting, the white people go to them, mommy, I have a headache. The mom be like, oh my God, my baby has a headache, oh my God, it could be Ebola, it could be SARS. She goes to Google, ba-ba-ba-ba-ba, signs of headache, ba-ba-ba, hey, my God, it's asthma, oh my God. And then she picks phone calls, 911, ambulance comes to pick the kid to the hospital. Headache. Come to my house, I have a headache, I go to my mama, me tear me, I'm like, me tear ya. And I want it. One year, and I know, panic. Now I'm not a cancer, and amazingly, I'll go and come and I'm fine. A round of applause for my dear moms, man. Wonderful people. Wonderful. And most of you wonder, you know, so I was motivated to be a doctor because I thought it was easy. You come to my clinic, doctor, tell me, boss, call me. And then your family, it's not the same. You know, unlike white settings, white people, there's a one-to-one doctor-to-patient ratio. You know, so you get the time to attend to a patient. Ghana, it's a 1 to 20 million people, man. Doctor, 20 million patients. So a white patient and the doctor can have a discussion. Doctor, what is wrong with me? The doctor will be like, oh my God, it breaks my heart to tell you this, but your lab results are in them. You have malaria. That is how they break malaria news. Ghana clinic. The place is choked. You want me to spend 30 minutes on you? No. They send the nurse out with your diagnosis. Mommy, if you are bad, oh, my mom's up. Who are malaria? Because you are good. I drop my mouth. Hey, now who did you have to tell me? What malaria? Because you are good. Mommy. Ghana, man, a round of applause for Ghanaians. You are wonderful people, you know. And I love my job, especially when I meet old patients, if any of you here, 50 years and above, you are wonderful, man. Especially those of you who work at the district assemblies. Hey, you people can lie. You can ask them, how old are you? I said, doctor, at the end, and the end, they say, how old are you? Tell me. Because they know they lie about their age. When you ask them their age, they want to lie more. You know, some of them give it to you like you ask them for lotto numbers. Mr. Ayn, how old are you? So, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60. Strike the average. I'm like, wow. And some of them, give it to you like it's a journey they are going through. Mr. Ani, how old are you? Oh, it's a CRD. Meaning I'm 45. Meaning I'm 50. And Chenegu 60. And they are jogging. And some of them give you options to choose from. That is what one thing I don't understand. Options. Like, Mr. Ani, how old are you? Dr. Apedieni. And the president saying, oh, say your war. Real age. And your war buying it. Oh, real age, 66. I'm buying 44. Wow. Ghanaian patients, you know. But I only have a few minutes more and then I'll be done. But oh really? You guys are feeling me. Oh, round of applause for me. Yeah. Introduce myself to ladies like, hey, my name is Obi, I'm an eye doctor, but I don't know Ghanaian ladies. Anytime you tell them you're a doctor, that is when they forget about the date you guys have gone and they break their medical history. Like, oh, you're a doctor, oh, my eye, see,
it has been itching this side, and they bring my mom into her eyes. So
it's a date, man.
So I've changed. You ask me, what do you do? I say, oh, my name is Obi. I'm a gynecologist. Any problem? You don't have any problem? No problem? Okay, let's go on. And then it settles the matter. But I love Ghana because of our tribal understanding, for a better way. So you can give me a better way. Tribal, it's your one season. Drop better. Yeah, fufu. You know? Tolerance.
God bless you.
Tolerance. You know, so I was wondering if Jesus was born Ghanaian. Jesus was born Ghanaian. Which tribe will he be? Oh yeah, yes, give me an Ewe.
Obey you. Nah. Jesus will not be Ewe. No, but you.
No, look. An Ewe man will not be that meek and humble for you to kill him like that. No. You put the nail in every Jesus' hand. You feel it in your ribs. Put the nail back at this.
But why are they put the nail for your hand?
I bet you've not asked for my permission. Which other tribe? Ashanti. I forget. God will not. Jesus will not be Ashanti. Ashanti person, before you kill him, man, he has to grab to you. Yeah, I'm going to come.
How many people, they don't talk much? You go. Yeah, the first. Come first, man. You just said 3 days later, I'm not sure you were lying. You to me, Madina, what lie? No revenge, you were lying. Yeah, no fast. Come on, man. Come on.
I believe, you know, imagine how that Jesus, like, on the cross, and then the guy, Jesus, free yourself and
we do bunny in the middle of the year.
But I believe Jesus can only be a fanti. Round of applause for fanties. Fanties, you rock. It's only a fanti man who will be meek and humble for you to slaughter and kill him. Our room.
Hey,
and beg for forgiveness. God, such a one. Die. Thank you very much. My name is Obi. Spread the gospel, man. I'm funny. God bless you.